liked Apple. They showed the new products. They talked about the new augmented reality. They talked about the apps. They have they also have a feature that with your phone, with texting, that when you're in the car, you can set it to send out a message. When, if somebody texts you, you can send out a message saying, I'm driving, I can't answer you.
An auto set that.
Yes, yes. So it kind of locks it where you won't take the call, which I think is great.
I think that's a great statement.
It's a good step.
Yes.
It's a good step in a way. But now we're talking Apple. Now, what's the advantage? Because here's the complaints I heard. People have been complaining that it's too expensive. Mm-hmm. It's more expensive. It's more expensive than the other devices. And I had a list of the prices. Let me bring this.
So we'll have they named the Apple device, or is it?
It's called HomePod, which I'm not too happy with, but I'm not. Yeah.
It's called a pod.
HomePod.
HomePod. That's not cute. You probably
it's can not catchy.
There's nothing cute about HomePod.
Okay. Not catchy. It's not catchy.
No, they need to send that back to a focus group.
They need to send that back to the focus group. Okay, I had a list of the prices. Go ahead. I'm just looking for my list of the prices that I had. That
so will it turn on your TV, TJ?
If you have a smart TV, like it connects to, I believe it's called Nest, where you buy these little adapter things and you plug it in, and I think it becomes a smart. If it's like that, I believe you can. Okay. But right now,
because they have Apple TV, and I was just thinking, okay, it makes sense that it would be able to turn on your Apple TV.
Well, now it does play. It uses AirPlay, so it will. It can play through your TV if you have the Apple TV.
Yeah. Okay. So it could probably turn it on too. Okay.
Right. So I'm trying to bring. Can't find my list of prices because that was one. Here it is. There was a complaint. And my internet is slowing down. What's going on? Okay, here we go.
You got about 3,000 devices over there. You got a lot of nerve.
Oh, I got a bunch of stuff. This home is so connected. Now, let me tell you, when my neighbors come over, their eyes just go, well, you got like 5 TVs and like 6 computers, like all those computers. And like how many? Like, okay.
Hey, Carol.
That's how it is. So now here's a list of. The Amazon has an Echo Dot that's $50. They have a Tap that's $130. Google Home is $130. The Amazon Echo is $180. They have an Amazon Echo Look. I think, I'm not sure what's the difference between the Echo and the Echo Look, but I think it's a higher service or different service from the Echo. That's $200.
Uh-huh.
And then they have the Apple HomePod, which is $350. So they're saying, wow, that's too pricey. $350 when the others are like $130, $120, whatever.
Okay, so my question is, mm-hmm. What makes it stand out from the crowd? Is it just that because we all have Apple products, it connects all our Apple products?
You got it. That's the answer. This is a winner for people who have Apple devices because Apple devices work together seamlessly, all because of the ID that you use to sign on to everything.
Okay.
So you when you have that that iCloud account, that iCloud ID, I'm losing a blank on the name. It has a name, but it's the ID that you use for Apple that you sign in for everything because. For example, my daughter had a MacBook Pro, like an older one. And then I had a newer MacBook Pro, but something happened and I needed to use hers. And so I logged in with it and I was like, it just installed everything that I had, like apps. And I was like, whoa.
From your new device, you could see it on. Right. So let me see if I understand. From your new device, you could see it on her old device.
On hers, because whatever I had installed. I can install there. It just automatically went over.
So it just migrated.
The Apple ID. That's what it's called. The Apple ID. Your Apple ID mm-hmm. is your key. That's the thing that lets you go around and open up different things on different devices.
Okay.
So if you have an iPhone and an iPod, an iPhone, iPad, an iMac or a MacBook, or whatever device you have, and you log in with the ID, they're all connected. Because you now you can do if you copy something on, say, an iMac, you can go to the iPad and paste it.
Okay.
And it's all because of the operating system. So it's all integrated.
Okay. So this is what they mean by that term integration. And yeah. I understand seamless.
So what, think about it like this. So if you make, say you get the HomePod and you're at home and you're cooking or whatever, and I got to remember the doctor's appointment next week or whatever. So you tell, hey, sir, he set me a reminder for next Tuesday at 5 p.m. doctor's appointment. And Siri does it through the HomePod. But when you go to your computer or your iPad or your phone, it's going to be there too. So it's not, they all work together. It's kind of like a puzzle. They all pieces all fit together. And that's the selling point of the Apple products. People always say, well, why do you want them? Because you don't have, with Windows is a different setup where there's different pieces of the device, that like a computer has different pieces by different manufacturers. They have to write software and they have to update them. And if this manufacturer doesn't update their card, and you know, there's so many things going on with Windows, but Apple, their devices are made by Apple. Software is written for Apple. There's no 5, 10, 15, 20 manufacturers of printers and video cards and network cards and this, you know, there's so many pieces that are by different people.
Uh-huh.
Hard to keep that connected because you have to depend on that third person to write an update for your software for the printer to talk to the computer. Because see, the printer may be an HP printer and you may have a Dell computer and you need, everything has to be updated. And that was the big thing when I was working with IT, that with Windows, with PC, it was always drivers had to be updated.
Yes,
Did the manufacturer update? Is there an update for this? It was always, always, always chasing updated drivers. With Windows, you don't do any of that. I mean, Apple, you don't do any of that. There's none of that. You just, turn your computer on and the App Store will say, you have an update, and you just update. You know, it just automatic. Does that explain it for you?
Yes, it does. And it makes sense. I couldn't understand. Okay, I understand why there's no delay. And you know, you guys explained that to me when we were talking about the apps.
Right.
How Apple gets their apps first.
Yes, because... Think of it as platforms. You have a Windows platform and an Apple. On the Windows platform, you have Dell computers, Asus computers. There's different manufacturers. Okay, so if you buy a computer from Dell, there's parts inside that were made by third-party manufacturers.
Gotcha.
So if Windows makes an update, Dell has to say, okay, to this manufacturer of the video card, we need you to rewrite your code to work in the computer to work with Windows. So see how many people that is? How many people? With Apple, it's one person. It's one. One.
Mm-hmm.
One. Tim Cook says, okay, we need an update to the Mac OS. His people go to work on it, and they serve it up, and they push it out automatically. You turn your computer on, your Apple, and it says, you have an update. And you just update. That's it.
Hey Mary.
Yeah.
That's how I came to understand it, Mary, from all the conversations that I'd had with Terry and Fran about phones and rolling out new phones and why Apple gets their apps first. Why you always usually see it says available on iOS.
Mm-hmm. That's why. Because with smartphones, you have Apple, which is a closed system. And then you have Android and Windows, where they have Motorola that makes a phone. Samsung makes a phone, but it's all Android based. See, so the operating system of Google Android has to fit each. It's like different size shoes. You got to make a foot that fits in. A foot has to fit each shoe. So that's hard, right? It's hard.
Yeah.
But Apple is one shoe, one foot, one shoe, one size, one shoe. Everything you put it on and you go.
One size fits all.
Right. But the Android people over there are trying to stick that foot in each shoe and say, make it work, make it work, make it like Tim Gunn, make it work, make it work, make it work.
So we got a bunch of Cinderella issues over there.
There's more ingredients in the pie of Android. With Apple, there's an apple. Android has different rhubarb, peach, and raspberry, blueberry, and they all gotta be the same. Yes.
don't hate, girl.
So and let's get into it, because this is why people, they're most complain about Apple with this product, and Apple products are very expensive. Yes, they are. But think about cars. When you buy a Mercedes or you buy, I'm not putting Chevy or Ford down, I'm just saying Mercedes, it has a level of excellence, a level of service, a level of quality, and you pay for that. Versus, okay, I'm going by cost, so I can only, my budget can only fit this much, so I need to go to Chevy or Ford and get their lowest whatever. See, but that's how it works with computers also. So I'm reading the comments. I think they have a little conversation.
I am disturbed by such a huge gap.
Mm-hmm.
But then, you know, maybe they're not talking to me.
Well, see, this is the thing. When it comes to computers and Apple versus Windows, it's, again, like I said, we talked about cable cord cutting. How do you want it? How do you want to use it? Most people are, you know, surfing the web, going to browser, send an email. They may do a little work. They may not. So if you're in the mid end where you want to work on a document or something from your job, you may want something a little bit more than something that just email and browsing. You may need a middle end computer, which is not going to cost, you know, the cost with that is still low. But if you're doing video editing, high end video editing, music production, gaming, that's where you need the more expensive equipment. And with people with, you know, they gravitate towards the Apple because of, you know, the quality of the device and the seamless integration. So if you're working on your iPad, you can save that and go to your iMac or your MacBook and work on it there without trying to figure out how to get it over there. They have something called AirDrop. You don't have to figure out how to get it on from one device to the other. Apple, they have AirDrop. It just, and it shows up when you share it. It says, do you want, and the little computer, and you touch it and it goes over there. Or they have the iCloud, which I use a lot to move the files around.
Okay.
But see, it depends on how you work, what you do, and how much you want to spend. Now, the Apple is there and it's more expensive, but you don't have to buy Apple. There's other choices. So that's why I say with this voice assistant speaker, it is on the high end, but you know, if you've got all Apple products and you can afford it, then you get the Apple. You go with it because it works together.